Hi guys, welcome back to the channel, or welcome to the channel if you're new. Welcome to Vlogmas! I'm so excited, also a little bit nervous because I've never done this before, so we'll see how it goes. Look who I'm joined with! It's Rochelle Shell. So we're up in Auckland, and Phil's here as well. Say hi, hi Phil. We came up here just for the weekend for Rachel's 21st. So I filmed a few clips which I will include in this video here, because a lot of today is going to be traveling because we're going home today. A rundown quickly of what we've been up to, pretty much just shopping. So we went to two malls. I know.
No sad. Surprises.
No surprises. And then we had Rachel's 21st yesterday night. So I will put the clips that I filmed in those couple of days in now.
So once again, we've got some snacks for the road. So we got some of these, which are the natural soft jellies fruit salad. I really, really like these. We got two packs of the bluebird chips because I think they were like two packs for like $3 or something. So these are Phil's ones. These are the grilled pepper steak. And then, no surprise, I got the thinly cut salt and vinegar chips. I'm so excited for these. We have two of these Cadbury Christmas edition chocolates. They're just like top deck, but like in the shape of Christmas trees, which I thought was very appropriate coming into the festive season. And these were only like $2 each. I was gonna make brownie, but I completely forgot about it. Those are our snacks that we're working with this time. I packaged up Rachel's card already. I forgot to show you guys, but for my 16th birthday, she got me like a singing card that was really, really loud. I got her one that says, "Watch me whip, watch me nay nay," and it's like the song. Just written this on the front and the back. See how long it takes her. Hey! Hey,
hi!
How
was the trip?
Yeah, it was all good.
It's good.
Yeah.
Hi, how are you?
Hey.
Hi, Paige is vlogging people.
Okay, don't open your eyes yet.
Feels like an envelope.
Okay, open.
Oh my gosh. I'm scared to open.
Got it.
Oh my gosh. Thank you, darling.
That's so good.
What did mine say again? I can't remember.
Yours was about the shopping trolley. Yeah.
Yeah, I won't be buying that.
Yeah,
much.
Yeah. Thank you.
That looks so good.
So we got a few things from Lush. So I'm gonna start with the thing that's not Christmassy first. So I got another one of these Let the Good Times Roll facial cleansers because I'm currently out of mine, and if you guys have been on my channel for a while, you'll know that I love this stuff. My skin really loves this stuff, and I've been out of it for 2 weeks and my skin's starting to play up. And then the last few things in here are Christmassy. Another one of the Snow Fairy body conditioners. Phil and I have had this before and we really like it. I just don't like the new packaging. I like the scent of the body conditioner, but the shower gels are too sweet for me. And then I just got two of the mini shower gels. So I've got the Yognog Christmas one and the Happy Christmas one. I was gonna get the full size of this one, but I really wanted to get this one as well, so I just thought we'll just get two of the little like travel size ones, because we've already got like the full size Body Shop ones from this year, and we've also got a few of the Lush ones from last year still. Just thought that'll kind of do us. So Phil actually bought this because he really liked this. So we bought this from Bed Bath & Table. It's just like a countdown kind of to Christmas thing. So I think you move this guy along what day it is. So I just thought that could be a little bit of fun. And this one was like on sale for like 10 bucks down from like 25. We went into Mecca, so we just got a couple of things in here. So I got one of these Mario Badescu drying lotions, just because everybody always raves about this stuff, but I'd never tried it before, so I thought we may as well try it, and I'm hoping that it lasts a while. But yeah, I'm really excited to try that one. And Phil bought this, which is the Soap and Glory, the scrub of your life. We don't really have a lot of like exfoliating scrubs at home, so I just thought we'd grab another one. And this one was only like $15. I'm excited to give that one a go because I've heard a lot of good stuff about this brand as well, but I've never tried it. And the last thing I bought was actually this, which I bought yesterday at Rachel's mall where she works. It's just the Benefit Goof Proof Brow Pencil. It's just the mini because I haven't tried this before, so I thought I'll just try the mini first, and if I like it then I'll go and purchase the full size. But I tried it today and I really really like it. It's really easy to use, which is good because I'm very new at filling in my eyebrow. And this one's in the shade 3.5.
As a mum, it's a real blessing and a real comfort, you know, when your child is away, to know that she's got such a great group of friends and friends from the acting course and from different places. You know, it's a comfort to know that she's cared for and that she has genuine friends who really do care about her welfare. So it's a little thoughts as we were travelling here that were going over my mind, and I'll keep it fairly brief, but one of the things that was really impressed upon me was about Rachel's integrity. As a mum, I want to speak well of her, and I want to speak well of her publicly. That's one of the things that I know about you, Rachel, and being true to who you are. One of the things I was thinking of, you know, when you have this tiny baby and it's born and you look at it and you think, you know, I can't imagine what this child is going to look like when you're an adult, when you're growing up. There's just no way you can possibly imagine. But you can see little character traits come through as they're growing, and those things, in hindsight, you look back and you think, oh, it was there when she was tiny. There's a part in it where Jo, who's the passionate writer, the passionate one, and she's had talking to her, who they call mum, and she looks at other people's lives, and I know you're not like this because you're passionate about, you know, what you want to do in life, and she's frustrated because she's like, you know, I wish I could be like, or I'm different to them, why can't I be like other people, why can't I just be happy with just being quite normal sort of thing. And Mummy says to her, and I'm sorry I've lost it, but she says, Jo, you have so many extraordinary gifts, and talents, how can you possibly expect to live an ordinary life? That's something that I see in you, Rachel, is that you have, you know, so much potential, and there are so many people with incredible potential in their lives, but they never use that potential. They never step out, they're too afraid to take that step, and that's something I've seen you do time and time again, to stay true to your convictions. Wishing you all the best for your future, and my prayer for you is that, you know, you're called with a purpose, and that you'll know just the success and all that you're called to do.
And it wasn't that long after that that we heard there was someone on the way. I can't remember if we knew it was Rachel or not, whether it was a boy or a girl, but it turned out to be Rachel. When we thought about naming Rachel, we sort of thought, well, what are we going to call it? The word joy came to mind. I know Rachel may not sort of like this labouring us too much, but we really did feel when we prayed about what the name would be, that she would be someone that would bring a lot of joy into our lives, and also she would bring a lot of joy into other people's lives as well. So, and that proved to be the case. She's been an absolute delight to have most of the time. And she learnt to talk very, very quickly, and one of the words that she learnt to say, I think it might be the first or second word, was shoe. So one night Karen went out, and I had to look after Rachel and do all the things that Karen normally did, and Rachel was a bit agitated that night and kept telling me about shoe, shoe, shoe. So I gave her a shoe, that didn't help the situation at all. And anyway, so Karen came back and found Rachel asleep with a shoe next to her. Another one was Raul. That was Rachel. So that was how she called herself Raul for the first month or two before she mastered the Rachel. She's also say it's a lovely sunny day out there. We got that from us, so we pulled back the curtains and said, oh, it's a lovely sunny day out there. And then one day we heard it went back to us. Rachel learned to walk pretty fast as well, so she was up and down in no time, and seemed fast anyway. And she'd come into our bedroom in the morning, myself and Karen would be looking forward to a sleeper. And it was like, oh, Rachel's going to snuggle in the big bed. And I was looking at any of that. She said, no, go for a walk. I want to go for a walk. And of course, we had to get up and go for a walk and do some adventuring. So that was a bit of a start of Rachel being a bit of an adventurer.
My name is Paige. I've had the privilege of knowing Rachel now since we were both in about year 7, sorry. I thought she was such a weirdo and so crazy back in the day, and I never ever thought we would be friends. It was only when I was in year 9, when I was 13, that I realised I was just as crazy as she is. We had a lot of fun memories over these past 8 years. One of my favourites was when Rachel got sent outside in the rain one lunchtime because we blamed her for another friend walking across the tables in the class and the teacher fully believed us. Or even just yesterday when you shoved your cardboard bag full of groceries and we joked that you looked like Kevin from Home Alone when he's carrying all the groceries home. Then the bottom of your bag started to break as well. We always did everything together, from fundraising by baking cookies and selling them all within 2 hours, to multiple photo shoots together in the P-Lab, which is what we called photography back in the day, and going to Christmas in the Park last year and watching the fireworks. I can always count on Rachel, whether it's for advice, someone to whinge to, or someone to get absolutely insane with me. You're very talented with your acting, which I know a lot of people have mentioned, but you've got a real gift for it. 21 looks so good on you, and I swear you don't age at all. Thank you so much for being an amazing best friend, and I couldn't ask for anyone better. I love you so much, and I don't know where I'd be without you. Thanks.
Just go down the first layer.
Yeah, that's not my fault.
It's a blind fit.
Oh, here we go.
He wants to have a birthday.
I'm as good myself.
See ya.
We're gonna sing happy birthday while Rachel.
Oh no, I don't.
Yeah.
Yep, that's as far as I go.
yeah, that's pretty much all we've been up to. Today we're just filling up with petrol at the moment. As you can see, Phil is doing that at the moment. And then we're gonna head out and get breakfast. We're probably just gonna go to the coffee club, and then it's just gonna be packing up the stuff and heading home. I'm kind of sad to be leaving, to be honest.
Yeah.
I'm excited to go home though and decorate my house. I'll catch you guys at breakfast. Christmas stuff there. Oh, there you go, you got your $5 trees down there.
I got these ones.
That's quite cool.
Yeah, it's... Oh, it doesn't say how long. I love the rainbow one, the rainbow one's cute. That's right, they've got like baubles for like $2. I'd love a green one, but like we've got nowhere to put it because we've got a big one. Pretty cheap. Cool, now let's find some baubles.
Need some decorations for it.
Got baubles. They've got like more in the actual like thing over there though.
I don't know where I'm going.
Just go straight and down. Yeah, yeah, down here. Got all your decorations. I've got so much of this stuff. I love this, but it doesn't match my theme this year. But it is really cute.
Christmas.
It is, eh? These are really cute. Like, I really like these. But, like, I've got a bigger one of these.
Oh, you turn it on.
Yeah, they light up.
Is it supposed to, like...
Sometimes you have to pull... Yeah, you got to pull that thing out to light it up. Yeah.
Oh, this is, like, the thing for the
picture. Yeah, the light up ones. I think they're really cute. And the trees... No, we don't have one of those. I did really like them.
I just grab like a small little
ball. Small thing of baubles.
The small ones.
They should have, they normally
like
have like,
to go on the top, you know?
Like a star.
These are cute. This is kind of dark.
They've got like smaller ones somewhere. They should do. Their Kmart is a mess. These low-key freak me out.
Oh, this is like a...
I think that's really cute. The little Santas. I wish they had these in like rose gold. Oh, the poor nutcracker. Where's his legs? He's been cut in half. Yeah, these. Oh, the poor reindeers. Why are they all falling down? I think they're really cute. And these.
Is the snow like moon or just?
No, it's not a snow globe, honey. The red and the gold's pretty. We're going for rose gold, but there's not a lot of rose gold in these.
Yeah.
And they don't seem to have the $2 ones.
Can I get these?
Yeah, I reckon get those. Well, because your tree's green too, so I think it'll look nice. Classic colours. Nice. Do you want tinsel? Tinsel lights?
I've got lights at home.
Ah, put them out like that, yeah. Oh! Gonna fall. He's really cute though, eh? Like in a weird way, he's really cute.
In a very strange way.
Yeah.
Okay, my lipstick is probably wearing off a little bit, but that's okay. So it is a little bit later on now. It's like 4:30-ish, and we're just leaving Auckland now. Yeah, there's not really gonna be much to vlog, really. So I hope you have enjoyed the content that I filmed over this little weekend trip. Sorry that yesterday came at Christmas shop with me, it was up quite late. I tried to upload it this morning before we went out, and the internet wasn't as fast as the internet is at home. So I left it uploading while we were out. and the computer went on sleep, and I think when it went on sleep it stopped the uploading. So I came back and turned it on and it was at like half, and it was like 3 o'clock, and I'm like, well, I don't want to be there until it is finished uploading, because otherwise we're going to be here all night, and obviously like we've got a long journey home. Sorry about that, but I do really hope you guys enjoyed it anyways. I'll catch you guys when we're at home.
Close from 5. Oh well, next time I come here.
Okay, excuse my very rank appearance. As you may be able to see by the background, I've made it back home. I am so tired. It is so late. It is 35 minutes past 11. I've just been sat at the computer. My battery is flashing at me, but I have just uploaded my new video, so make sure you go and check it out. I'll leave a link to it in the description box below, but yeah, it's just the one that I uploaded yesterday. So my battery is flashing at me, so I'm gonna keep this short. But yeah, I really hope you guys have enjoyed today. If you did, please make sure to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, turn on the notifications, and also check out my social media. My social media is all linked down below in the description. I'm gonna save my advent calendar for tomorrow, because as it gets later on in the evening, I just can't eat stuff, otherwise I feel really, really sick. So my battery just died, but I'm so, so tired, and Phil and I are just gonna go to bed. Get excited for Vlogmas, guys. I'm nervous, but I mean, we'll see how it goes. I just can't promise that every day is gonna be like a fun vlog, because obviously like I work like 30 hours a week, and I'm gonna have to edit my sit down videos and my vlogs as well each day. So we'll try and get some fun stuff done, but yeah, I'm doing my best, guys, so please work with me here. It's my first year doing this, so I will see you guys for another video tomorrow. Bye.